Welcome, class of 2023, to the 1 month until move-in housing webinar. We are so excited to be here with you tonight to give you a little bit more information about move-in, about living on campus, as well as answer any of your questions that you have. Feel free to type them right in that chat box. We're here from the offices of Residence Life and Housing Operations, and we will introduce ourselves so you know who you're chatting with tonight. My name is Rebecca Watson. I work in Housing Operations.
Hi, my name is Nicole Reeder, and I serve as a first-year building supervisor within Residence Life.
Awesome. So we'll go ahead and get started.
All right. So within the first-year area at Emory, we focus on three different areas. So we focus on connecting with the community, fostering academic success, and then understanding ongoing transitions of students. And so even moving past this within Residence Life, we have a residential education for you as well. And so this is something that me and my team work on throughout the year. So these are just some of the focus areas that we have going into your first year. And then what do we do? So we do a lot of different things here at Emory, a lot of different fun traditions and just different experiences for you to get involved in. So I'm just gonna walk through each of the ones on the slide just so that you have an idea. But Songfest. Songfest is an annual tradition, so if you want to click on that YouTube link, you can watch what this looks like. But Songfest is basically a competition every fall amongst the residence halls. So each residence hall will come up with a song and a dance, lyrics, things like that. So our residential staff come up with that routine for you, and then every residence hall competes. So it's really, really fun. You do it during the first week of school, and it's just a great way to bond with your community. We also do six-week kickoff, so this is a six-week agendas that we do with first-year students just to walk through like meetings, what's going on campus, how to get involved, things like that. Dooley's Debates is also a tradition in the fall. And so Dooley's Debates is basically put on by the Barclay Forum and then by the Emory Conversation Project. And this is just to get students talking about like common issues and engage in dialogue with one another. First year semi-formal, this is in November. So first year semi-formal is a really, really fun opportunity by Residence Life. And this is for you to go off campus, meet with other students, dress up, and just participate with a lot of the first year class. So that's really, really fun. And then first year crossover, that takes place in the spring. And this is an annual tradition for you to cross into your sophomore year.
So the two images that are on the screen right now, you're seeing one that's from the first year semi-formal, and there's a dinosaur skeleton in the back. So we hold the first year semi-formal at the Fernbank Museum of Natural Science here in Atlanta. And so it's pretty cool. You get to, you know, dance and have this dressed up experience with dinosaurs and things like that. And then the other one with the folks in green t-shirts, that's from Songfest. And that's just an example of some of the cool things that are happening here in the first year program at Emory. So here is the fun slide with all the important dates and things to not forget. So first year student move-in day primarily is on Saturday, August 24th. If you're participating in a pre-orientation program, your move-in date is gonna be on Tuesday, August 20th. So if you're participating in SOAR, Ignite, STEM Pathways, or the International Student Welcome Program, your move-in day is going to be on August 20th. We're going to dive into that a little bit more later on in this slideshow presentation for you, but these are definitely key dates to hang on to. As we get later into the semester, you know, heads up, the first day of classes is Wednesday, August 28th, and then Songfest takes place the very next day on August 29th. So right after you move in, as you go through orientation and the Toward Emory program, there's time carved out for your residence hall to practice and to get, you know, get everything polished and looking good. November 10th is that first year semi-formal we just talked about. December 19th, residence halls will close at 12 noon for winter break. So this is right after your finals have ended, and all of our residence halls for first year students do close for winter break. January 12th, they will reopen at 10 a.m. And then May 7th, they'll close again for the end of the academic year. You guys are doing tons of questions and chatting, and we're chatting back with you, so this is awesome. Keep the questions coming. So a little bit more about move-in explained. So again, that Tuesday, August 20th with the pre-orientation program move-in, again, SOAR, International Student Welcome, Ignite, and STEM Pathways. So we recommend that before August 20th, you review the specific instructions from your individual program. So your program, whichever one you signed up for, is going to give you specific move-in information. You'll also get some information from the housing office as well. But again, review all that stuff ahead of time. Basically, in a nutshell, you're going to arrive to campus, you're going to check into your residence hall, you will get more specific information as we get closer to August 20th as to what that looks like, so where you go and things like that. And then you want to make sure to check into your pre-orientation program check-in, and that will take place at the Emory Student Center. You can't miss the building, right in the middle of campus, beautiful new building. For those of you that are not doing a pre-orientation program, and most of you are not, your move-in day is on Saturday, August 24th. August 1st, you will receive your move-in time slot. That will be posted on your My Housing page. So the same exact place that you went to get your actual housing assignment is where you will go to get your move-in time slot. It'll be right at the top bar there, next to your name and picture. In a nutshell, you're going to arrive to campus. We're going to have lots of signage to help direct you along the way. You're going to follow directions to the drop-off zone for your residence hall. You're going to unload and relocate your vehicle. We will have helpers around on the 24th to assist you with that, and lots of signage to direct you to the appropriate parking deck based on your residence hall. And you know, if your parents want to move the car and then meet you back at your room so they can help you set up and meet your roommate and all of that fun stuff. And then right after move-in is over in the morning, you'll start attending your orientation events. We do offer a pre-arrival packet, and that will be available starting August 8th. So you'll get things emailed to you that you can print out. You can, you know, pull up on your phone when you actually arrive for move-in, however you want to do it, but it'll be maps, instructions, parking information, and things like that. So we're not going to leave you hanging. We know there's a lot of questions. A lot of those will be answered after August 1st and then again after August 8th.
All right, and so we thought it would be fun to put together a slide on some advice from current students. And so the first thing is just, it's never too early to learn how to do your laundry. Truly, we have laundry within every single residence hall, and this is for you just to use as you need. And so it's never too early to learn. Next thing, like, get to know your roommate. And so once these, you know, housing assignments are out, once you can go on your My Housing portal, it's good to just reach out, just engage with your future roommate. Communicate face-to-face as much as possible. So again, like you can notice on this slide just the theme of getting engaged, however that looks like for you. So participating in this webinar, reaching out through social media, reaching out through email, just reach out because there's so many people who want to know you and want to connect you with resources. And so some frequently asked questions. And so even just like scrolling through this question list, there's a lot of questions about what my room will look like, what furniture is included, et cetera. And all of this can be found on our website. So we listed for you here furniture dimensions. So if that's important for you to start designing your space, figuring out what that looks like for you. And then also your building in particular. So just acknowledging that each building looks different. Each building is designed differently. All housing will have accommodations that you need for your first year. And so please just take a tour of our first year halls. And again, there is a link at the bottom for you. And then here, so how can I make my room feel like my own space? And this is truly just up to you, bringing something that will make your room feel like home, just making sure that you follow our housing policies. So avoiding, you know, adhesive materials, using thumbtacks, et cetera. So we want you to make your space your own. Also, you know, following housing policies. So what does that look like for you? Whether it's, you know, bringing some of your own, like posters, bringing your own pillows, blankets, like everything like that. So what do you need to make this place feel like home to you?
I would definitely reiterate the avoiding adhesive materials in order to hang things up. So command hooks and command strips sound like a great idea, but at the end of the year when you go to remove them, they will take off some of the paint. We would definitely recommend push pins and thumbtacks to hang up most of the stuff that you're looking to hang up, mm-hmm. Because those command hooks will do a number on the walls and you don't want to be in that position. So what do I need to bring and what not to bring? So we have put together a couple lists for you that you can find on our website. If you click this link here, we have a what to bring and a what not to bring list there. We're seeing a lot of activity in the chat window here with lots of questions about linen sizes, twin XL, that's definitely the linen size you want to go for. A lot of questions about fridges and things like that, which we'll get to in a minute. But yeah, definitely take a look at what you can and cannot bring, particularly when it comes to things like power cords, power extension cords, power strips, surge protectors, things like that. There's all kinds of good stuff on there. There's also a list there of sustainable options for what you can bring, or suggestions for what to bring. We are a very sustainable green campus here at Emory, which you'll definitely see when you move in. And so if you're looking for some alternative things that would help be a little bit more green, that's a great place to look as well.
Okay, so some frequently asked questions again. So can I bring a microwave and or refrigerator? Yes. However, these have to be the appropriate size, and so we've listed that size for you here. Emory also has partnered with a company that provides microfridges and microwaves, and so this is available for you to rent. And so if you're interested in this system, please just make sure to click on the link. But this microfridge and will be delivered to your residence hall, and then after you leave, we will be taking it out. So if you do decide to rent, this is a great option for you. Do you recommend renter's insurance? Yes. This is going to be a space provided by Emory Housing, and so while we provide the space, all of your possessions within the space should be made sure to be covered by renter's insurance. So yes, we do recommend that.
So just a reminder, it's one mini fridge or micro fridge per room. So you'll want to coordinate that with your roommate if you are in a double room. Yeah, that's it on that. So can I move early? So move in early, excuse me. All students should plan to move in on August 24th. And again, if you're doing a pre-approved program, such as international student orientation, select athletes, things like that, you will get information regarding your earlier move-in. The meal plan does start on Sunday, August 25th. You may be asking, but you're telling me I moved in the 24th, but you're not feeding me till the 25th. We will definitely be feeding you on the 24th as part of orientation, so don't worry about that, but your actual swipes on your meal plan don't start until the 25th. So a lot of you are asking in the comments as well about shipping things ahead of time. This is definitely something that a lot of folks take advantage of. You will get your MSC mailbox number on your My Housing page starting August 1st, and so you'll be able to see your shipping address there and your mailing address in general. So we've listed out on the screen here how you want to address your mail. It's really important that you put Emory University-Main Campus if you're living here in a first-year residence hall. If you're a transfer student who's joining us tonight and you are living at Claremont, you're going to want to put Claremont Campus instead of the Main Campus. That just helps the mailroom kind of sort things out ahead of time. And then you're going to put your MSC box on there as well. So if you're an international student, you can begin shipping your items to campus beginning on August 5th. And if you're a domestic student, you can begin shipping on August 12th. There'll be more information about where you pick these packages up on move-in and when you arrive and things like that. You can find all this information on the website that's listed there below, the orientation website. And there's also a link on our housing website. Cool. And then we've given you a link here to our housing website. It's emory.edu/housing, super simple. And if you have any other questions related to housing, feel free to email us. It's also super simple, housing@emory.edu, or our Facebook link is down there below. So in the meantime, this is it for us with a formal session. We will now open this up to questions. I know you guys are typing furiously and we're trying to answer as quickly as we can, but if you have any other questions that you would like to ask now, feel free to put those in the question box.
I can take this first one.
Sure.
Access to cleaning supplies. It depends on what type of cleaning supply, so I'm just going to refer to vacuum cleaners. Yes. We have vacuum cleaners in the halls for you to rent out with our residential staff. Cleaning supplies outside of that, no. So we have a vacuum cleaner. We also have things like kitchen supplies or like even like food items. Like we have items for you within the residence halls that can be arranged with your RA or SAs.
And that's a good point. If you live in a, if your assignment is in a room that's a suite, so you have an attached bathroom, you're responsible for cleaning that bathroom. Our residential cleaning staff does not go in and clean that bathroom for you. If you don't have a restroom attached to your room and you're using the hall restroom, we will definitely clean that every day for you. So there's asking, is there somewhere we can see photos of a room in Raoul? Yep, check out our website. There are photos there. Do pool tables exist anywhere on campus? I'll let you jump in on that one.
I'm trying to think. Pool tables in particular, yes. Locations, unsure, to be completely honest. But we do have a lot of different facilities for you on campus in terms of like recreational spaces or like hangout spaces. And so within the residence halls, it truly depends. Within first year residence halls, my answer is no.
So there's a question, how will I know bed one from bed two when I enter the dorm because I'm assigned to one bed and my roommate another? So there's no specific designation of bed one and bed two. It's just in, you know, our housing software, there are two beds in the room, and so it says one of you is bed one and one of you is bed two. So when you arrive, mm-hmm. feel free to choose whichever bed you would like. You and your roommate can work that out.
I see a question about carpeted floors. This also depends on your residence hall. So do you want to talk about
yeah,
that?
So most of them are carpeted. We have a handful of rooms here and there that have been replaced with LVT vinyl flooring, but for the most part, you should be prepared that your space is going to be carpeted. Someone's asking, is there a time when the dorms lock? Great question.
Mm, yeah.
So the front door to your residence hall, to all residence halls, are locked at all times. You'll use your Emory card to gain access to the residence hall that you are assigned to. So you'll just tap that on the door. There's a little panel next to the door handle. You'll tap that and that will let you into the room, or into the door, into the building, excuse me. outside of that, there is no other, you know, the doors are locked at all times.
It's also worth noting as well that depending on the residence hall, some of these individual floors will also be locked. So it just depends. But some of the residence halls have that double security.
Is the gym free for Emory students?
Gym is included with your fees at Emory.
Yes. Are the beds twin size? It looks like we already answered
yes.
that. They're twin XL.
Mm-hmm.
Are kitchens and other amenities within the halls open 24/7?
That's a good question. So our kitchen and other amenities available 24/7? I think technically it depends. So technically, yes. The thing is when it comes to kitchen supplies, checking out those kitchen supplies, we do have RAs on call 24/7. But the thing to note is that some residence halls are going to have restrictions just depending on the building, because we don't want our staff responding at 3 a.m. to check out, you know, like a pot or a pan that could be returned the next day or could be returned by an earlier time. So are the amenities available 24/7? Yes, depending on the residence hall and depending on the cleanliness of that space. So those spaces can be shut down depending on if they're not meeting our standards within housing.
So there's a question about, does Dobbs have key card access as well?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, every single residence hall has key card access.
Mm-hmm. Dobbs, you would key into the main parlor and that gets you access to the entire building. The reason why there's not access on every floor or like a key swipe on every floor is just because of how old the building is. But yes, there's still access to the main
yeah.
building.
Does Smith Hall have an elevator? Oh, someone answered it.
Okay, great.
Great. Hopkins, which is attached to Smith, has the elevator.
I see a question on cooking equipment. So this depends. I would refer back to the list provided in the PowerPoint to see what exactly is allowed and what is not allowed. Hot plates and blenders, you want to go ahead?
Yeah, hot plates are not allowed. You're welcome. You know, the community kitchens in each residence hall will have a suitable substitution mm-hmm. for you. But definitely check out that link on our website that gives you a list of what you can bring and cannot bring.
Mm-hmm.
There's a question, if we're planning to raise our bed, do we need to bring a ladder? Great question.
So if you're planning to raise your bed as in like a common loft, no. But this depends on, yeah, no. Ladders are going to be provided, but some of the residence halls have junior lofts, and so those are going to be restricted with how high your bed can be lofted. But all material to loft your bed is provided by housing at move-in.
Do individual dorms have locks? So if you're talking about your individual bedroom door, yes. You will get a key at move-in, so an mm-hmm. actual old-school key is what we will give you, and that will lock your individual door. Again, you'll use your Emory card to unlock the building door. There's also a question about, can you use your Emory card to get into residence halls besides your own? So yes, you can get into the front door, into the lobby area of other residence halls, but you cannot get past the lobby area. So if you want to, you know, meet your friend there, get out from the rain,
mm-hmm.
But they would need to come down and get you, you know, escort you into the remainder of the building.
Mm-hmm.
When will we receive our Emory cards? Great question. Hopefully you've all uploaded your photos. Some of you still have not, but go ahead and do that if you have not. You will get your Emory card when you move in.
Mm-hmm.
You get it at check-in along with your key.
Mm-hmm. Do we have to pay to loft the bed? No. You do not have to pay to loft the bed. This is going to be something that you could do when you arrive to campus if you want to do that. But again, some residence halls have junior lofts, not full lofts. Has information about theme housing come out? It depends on what you're referring to with theme housing. So I might need more specifics.
How many showers are available in the community bathrooms in Termin? Lucky you, you have the building supervisor for Termin right here.
So in the community bathrooms, I'm not sure on the exact number, to be honest, so here I am on the spot. But yeah, I would say between 3 to 4 showers per community bathroom. There's plenty,
yes.
To be completely honest. Each floor, like 2 through 5 in Termin, have around 25 students, and there's 2 community bathrooms, so there's plenty of space. So for single-sex floors, no. So men and women are allowed to be within every community within a residence hall. But again, this can be a conversation with your RA when you get to campus, just if you have things that you want to bring up or concerns about having like both men and women within a community space, then that can be talked about with your staff when you get here.
It's also a great thing to work out with your roommate or things like that. Your RA can assist you with that as well.
Mm-hmm.
The photos of Raul look like the beds are lofted with the dresser under. Are they all that way? That's a total choice for you. The furniture mm-hmm. can, if you choose to loft the bed, the furniture can go underneath it. Some students prefer that. If you don't want to loft the bed, you're definitely able to keep the bed lower and have the dresser, to the side of that. So follow-up to the question about theme housing, she's asking for the mm-hmm. programs that you could apply to, such as social innovation ideas mm-hmm. and things like that. So that information for students that were selected for those communities did come out when assignments were released on July 1. If you were selected for that floor or that theme community, you got an email letting you know that information as well. So at this time, they're not accepting any more applications that needed to be submitted at the same time as the housing application.
That's a good question. I see So I see a question. Are the residence halls really closing on December 19th at noon? Yes. What happens if our flight home is booked for December 20th? So if you have any concerns about needing to stay late, you can apply through housing for that process. So I don't know if you want to talk about
that. Yeah. So that process doesn't open until much later in the semester. Mm-hmm. But definitely start those conversations with your RA, with your complex director, and your building supervisor earlier on. Are we allowed to rearrange the furniture in our rooms any way we like it? Absolutely, as long as you're not blocking anything that you shouldn't block.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of our halls have these little stickers on them that let you know if that, particularly when it comes to ventilation, that, you know, give Dooley wiggle room, you'll see those. So just don't block things you shouldn't be blocking, and make sure your means of egress is safe, mm-hmm. and you're welcome to rearrange things.
It's also worth noting that you can't take furniture out of the spaces.
Yes.
So whatever furniture we provide, we need to have that there at the end of the year. And so if you don't want something to be in that space, that needs to be a conversation with residence life staff. But the answer will be no. So all furniture should stay in the space that you are given.
Question about the community restrooms, and if they, it was up a little bit higher, but are the community restrooms co-ed or not? They are generally not co-ed. There is a male designated restroom and a female designated restroom. There's also a single use gender neutral restroom on almost every floor. Some of the halls don't have it, mm-hmm. On every floor, but they at least have one in the building. And so that can sometimes be a good option if you live on one end of the floor that's, you know, farther away from the restroom of your, you know, that would be mm-hmm. useful for you.
Mm-hmm. So there's a question about noise restrictions. And the answer is yes, we do have quiet hours. And this varies depending on where you live, in terms of like the specific times, but all mm-hmm. residence halls do have quiet hours. And then during finals, we have 24-hour quiet hours. And so those are enforced by our residence life staff. So the RA is on call. And so yes, the specific hours, again, will be talked about when you get to campus. So there's also a question, how is the residence hall closing on the 19th if the last exam is on the 21st? So all exams will take place prior to closing. So just note that there's an error in one of those things, but all exams will take place prior to when you leave. So yes. Oh, cleaning.
Ooh, yay, cleaning. Do we need to clean out our rooms when we go on breaks like winter or spring? So we would love for you to clean your room as frequently as you would like to clean your room. You don't have to take your things home with you, so when you leave for winter break and come back about a month later, you know, you're welcome to leave your items in your residence hall room. Just make sure you take with you anything that you would need in that 1 month time period. You know, your door is going to be locked. Facilities will be going in to do routine mm-hmm. maintenance during that time. Usually it's changing air filters or light bulbs or things like that. But you don't have to move completely out and then move completely in.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing for spring break. If you choose to leave over spring break, you do not need to take everything out with you. We definitely encourage, you know, frequent cleaning and things like that. Again, you're welcome to borrow the or sign out the vacuums or any of the kind of community supplies that we have there in the halls.
Mm-hmm. I want to go back to an earlier question. Are outside visitors allowed into the residence halls at all times? So there's two different things. So pizza delivery person, into the halls, no. They don't have access to the halls. You'll have to meet them outside the halls. Yes. A friend from home, we do have a visitation policy, and so that can be found in our housing policies online. So if you have any questions about, like, friends visiting, significant others visiting, you know, family visiting, yes, we have a visitation policy. So you can refer to that to have your friends come in town.
Questions about Wi-Fi and things like that. I know it's already been answered in the chat, but it's worth repeating. Yes, we do have Wi-Fi on campus. It's called Emory Unplugged, and it's accessible campus-wide. So you don't have to worry about setting up your own mm-hmm. Wi-Fi or things like that. Can you get two Emory cards? No, you get one Emory card. If you happen to lose that Emory card and you need to get another one, and then you find your first one a week later, your first one is dead. It will not work. None of the privileges that it once had will, you know, are in existence.
Mm-hmm.
So you have one active Emory card at a time, and just one Emory card.
Mm-hmm.
Any other questions? Yeah, so just to reiterate what we just mentioned for storing things over break, you don't need to find a storage unit or anything. You're welcome to leave your things in your residence hall over winter break. You just want to make sure that you're taking with you anything that you would need to access, because you will not be able to get back into your hall during that time period. The halls are closed. So make sure you take your medication, your laptops, anything like that that you will need in that 3 to 4 week time period.
So I see the question about Dobbs, and no, visitors will not have access. So I guess a better way to explain would be, so one of my buildings I supervise is Hamilton Homes. In Hamilton Homes, we have our entry to the lobby, which all students can swipe into at certain times, and then we have a second swipe per hallway. So one for the staircase, one for the first floor. In Dobbs, that single swipe access is treated like the floor access, if that makes sense. So you have to live in Dobbs to have key access to Dobbs. So Dobbs is not open to all campus to swipe into the lobby. That has to be just Dobbs students that live there for security reasons. So delivery people, no. No one can access it without given access.
Question about printers and how accessible they are. Would it be beneficial to have one in your room? Each residence hall does have a printer located somewhere within it in a common space. If you'd like to have one in your room, you're welcome to do that, but there are printers in each hall. And the library, of course, has lots of printers. Does Emory card work for room access or only hall access? It is only hall access. You will be issued a hard key, a brass key, at move-in that will work for your room. As far as decorating, are command hooks allowed? We strongly discourage command hooks because they will damage the walls. I know they claim that they don't, but they will damage our walls, so we would strongly recommend against the command hooks.
Mail.
Is there a way to send letters and mail from our dorms? Yes, so there is a mail center on campus. It's located on the bottom floor of FEW Hall, FEW Residence Hall. And yeah, you can mail things from there just like a regular post office. You can get stamps there, you know, whatever you need to do for that.
And pick up your packages.
Pick up
there.
Your packages.
Yeah. They do have hours. So they do have hours that they work during the school year. It's 9 to 6, or and then during the summer it's a little bit more restricted. So they operate full service mail center. I saw a question about storing items in your residence hall over the summer. And so the answer to that is no. So we have storage that we suggest off campus that you can use, things like that. But over the summer, we don't store in the same residence hall room.
Your assignment for your sophomore year is not going to be the same as it was in your first year, your freshman year. So there's no point in keeping things in your room because you're not going to be living there next year. What if I'm working on campus during the summer, have an internship at Emory, or taking a summer course? Will I not be allowed in the dorm? So we do offer summer housing for students that are enrolled in summer school courses. That is located in a different residence hall that's not a first-year residence hall. So if you are taking a summer class, you're definitely able to live there. If you have an internship, whether it's at Emory or somewhere else in Atlanta, we offer what's called SHIP. It's the Summer Intern Housing Program. You can find all this information on our website, but that is housing for students that have internships in the Atlanta area. And so again, that's in a different residence hall facility. It would not be in your current dorm, current residence hall assignment.
Let's see. Policy regarding lost keys.
Yeah, so if you lose your key, you will come to the designated service center for your residence hall. So here on main campus, we have a larger service center located in Raoul Hall, the first floor of Raoul Hall, which is where our offices are located, the Residence Life and Housing offices. And you will say, I lost my key, I need a new one. They will give you a loaner key for the time being. They're gonna ask you to fill out an electronic form, and we will get your lock changed, and they will charge you for that lock change because it does cost some money to get the locksmith to do that. And once your keys are in and keys are ready, they will contact you and say you can now pick your keys up. You and your roommate would then come back to the service center and pick up your key and sign for it.
All right. So laundry machines, yes, they are free. So they're included with your Emory fees. What address do we use for Amazon? This is just going to be your, what we were talking about with the main campus mail center. So you're going to be given an MSC number, which basically is just going to be your personal mailbox. And so you're going to ship items to your MSC number and then go pick them up at the FEW mail center.
And for move-in, the general school year, everything gets picked up at the FEW mail center. For move-in, because of the high volume of packages, they set up pods around campus closer to the residence halls. Mm-hmm. So depending on which residence hall you're in, you may actually be picking your packages up at the pod instead of at the mail center. But again, all that information will be available on the website and on mail services website and things like that. Questions about extra rods, if they want to hang extra clothing rods. It looks like it's been answered here, but mm-hmm. yeah, we won't provide extra rods, but you're welcome to provide your own as long as it does not damage anything in the room.
Yep.
Can delivery services like Amazon ship to an MSC number? Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, notifications. Mm-hmm. So I actually live on campus, and so I also use the mail center. So all these are just hitting close to home. So how will you be notified that we have mail? You're going to receive an email. And so you're going to receive an email that lets you know per package that you receive that you'll go pick that up. I also saw an earlier question about SA rooms differing from traditional residence hall rooms, and all accommodations will still be the same. The shape of the room, size of the room, things like that might differ, but that's a unique circumstance, I would say, and all accommodations are the same.
Is the new student center replacing the dock? Yes, the new student center did replace the dock. It's beautiful. It is a great space. We know you're going to love it. The new dining facility, the Dobbs Common Table. I just froze there. It's great, and yes, you're really going to love it there.
Do students need to supply their own laundry detergent? Yes. But again, if you need help with anything once you transition here, just feel free to reach out to SAs and RAs, and we can help you out. But laundry detergent, you're providing that. Drink water from the sink. Yes, water is safe to drink on Emory's campus. You are welcome to use things like a Brita filter, or use our water dispensers that we provide as well. And so I would say it's pretty common for students to use a water bottle and just refill at the refill stations.
Yeah, Nicole brings up a good point. A lot of our residence halls and a lot of our buildings on campus in general, academic buildings, things like that, have the refillable water bottle stations. So mm-hmm. you just put your water bottle up to it and it will fill it up for you there.
Is the food good? Yes, the food is really, really good.
So a lot of options,
yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Where can the schedule for orientation be found? Head to the orientation website, the Toward Emory website, and that will be up there.
Mm-hmm. If the duck was replaced, what is being used for now? This new building is in replacement of the duck. So this is, to my understanding, a completely new space.
Completely
the old
new.
Duck does not exist.
Yes.
And so this was built in its place.
Yep.
It's Songfest.
Yeah. Question about what's the difference between an SA and an RA?
Uh-huh. So the difference, an SA is a sophomore advisor, and these students are volunteer students who want to be in the residence halls and just honestly get to hang out with first-year students, really help to transition you all to campus. And so sophomore advisors are going to be our students who help assist in the residence halls that way. RAs, our resident advisors, are going to be juniors and seniors who apply to have more of an involvement with on-call and SAs are going to do a lot more programmatic things. RAs are going to be doing a lot more of the day-to-day crisis response, facilities management, things like that in the halls, as well as community building with you all. SAs are unique to first-year halls, so that's worth noting as well. And so depending on your floor community, you could have anywhere, you could have two SAs and one RA, or just a larger floor community. But that's the difference. Hopefully that helps.
So it's a question, what do we do in international orientation versus normal? You'll find out when you get here. some different things involved for you. Does the dining hall have options for people with dietary restrictions? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
There is a whole vegan line as well. They're specifically asking about vegan here. Is August 24th the move-in day for freshmen only or all students? So it's the move-in day for new students to campus. So that includes freshmen. It also includes transfer students. And our Oxford graduates who are going to be transitioning to Atlanta's campus will move in that day as well.
Mm-hmm.
But upper-class students move in on a later day.
To go off of the question with dietary restrictions as well, our dining facility is honestly fantastic. They label everything.
Yes.
So you'll see a little label for like gluten-free, labels for vegetarian, labels for vegan. So we have labels for everything. It's really, really easy to eat in our dining facility.
Mm-hmm. There's a question about when and how to apply for work-study jobs. So there is a work-study job fair that's held, I believe it's that Monday right after move-in.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can go, and lots of on-campus employers will be there, advertising and soliciting applicants for their jobs. So that's a great way to just kind of get yourself out there all at once. Definitely bring your resume with you, and you can meet folks right there, then and there.
And then question, what are meal exchanges? How do they work? So you will be able to go and swipe into the Dobbs Common Table and just, basically anytime that dining facility is open to come in for breakfast, lunch, dinner. Even sometimes there's like some midnight snacks. So there's a lot of different meal options. What are meal exchanges? That means access to the Dobbs Common Table, essentially.
Are there places near campus to buy groceries?
Mm-hmm. Yes. So near campus, it depends on what you mean by near campus, but we do have some shuttles that we provide for you specifically during move-in. And then also throughout the year, if you need help with that, to go to local stores and things like that for groceries. But near to campus, yes, it just depends on how far you're talking about, if you have access to a car, if you want to use our shuttle system, things like that.
We have Kroger and we have Publix that are nearby.
Yeah.
Is there a way other than MARTA for students to travel to or from downtown Atlanta? Some of our shuttles will get closer to downtown Atlanta depending on where you're trying to get to. And so definitely check out the parking transportation website that's linked here as well in the comments. They'll give you the shuttle routes and things like that. A lot of students will end up using a ride share like Uber or Lyft if they're trying to get different places. We see a lot of activity in the class of 2023 Facebook page or in the other Facebook pages for different classes, particularly around breaks and things like that. Folks will post, hey, I'm going to the airport at 10. Does somebody want to split a car or an Uber with me, things
like
that.
We also have airport shuttles.
Shuttles, stuff like that.
Yeah. So you'll get emails about all of that.
Good point. We have a farmer's market on campus every Tuesday. How can I forget about the farmer's market? So that's a great option for some different snacks and things like that. Does the AC work well or do you need a fan?
The AC does work well. But again, if it depends on, it depends on the temperature that you like, that things like that. But we do, you do have, some type of range within every residence hall to control that AC. Yes, it works well. Well, we know the shuttle schedules once we get on campus. Yes, you'll be getting emails about that as well. There's like apps that you can download as well to track our bus shuttles just directly on campus. And then also those shuttles to like downtown Atlanta, those shuttles for the Emory Experience shuttles. Yes, those should also be available on online as well.
So question about churches on campus or any info on nearby churches.
Mm-hmm.
We have a great office here on campus called the Office of Spiritual and Religious Life, and they're a great resource for getting connected with a variety of different denomination, religious churches and buildings and things like that. So I'm sure somebody will type that in here in the comments, or if not, just Google search on the Emory website, Office of Spiritual and Religious Life.
Ask, how cold does it get in Atlanta in the winter?
It depends what you think cold is. We do have some colder weather. I would definitely say you're going to want to have a winter jacket Get some gloves, scarf, things like that. You might only need to wear them a couple times, but for those couple days, you will definitely be glad that you have it.
I would also say, so I just moved to Atlanta last year. It rains a lot. And so if you don't have a rain jacket or even like shoes that are waterproof, that's something that I would look into as well before coming to campus. Let's see. What can I pay for with the money on the student ID? It depends on which type of dollars you have on your ID. So like Dooley dollars, for example, might purchase something different than Eagle dollars. And so that's worth looking into. But basically, those dollars, to my understanding, can be used at like our Cox Dining facility. Some of those dollars, depending on which one we're talking about, can be used at the bookstore. Some can even be used at the local restaurants as well.
So, question about snow. We have gotten snow, ice, things like that. If you are from a climate or a state that generally gets a lot of snow, what we get is probably not going to feel like snow to you. It's going to feel like a little dusting, but we do get some weather.
Does Emory have an electric scooter or bike service to get around campus? So in terms of does Emory provide this, does Emory have this? No, we don't advise this. However, we do have, you know, like Lime scooters and what's the other one? We have some of these around campus.
Right.
Do we advise them?
We generally discourage their use on campus. That the university is looking into if this is something that we want to continue seeing on campus or not. And so I would not plan on using one of those scooters on campus.
Mm-hmm.
Just plan on walking or using the shuttle services. The shuttles go everywhere. We use it all the time. I use it all the time. Nicole uses it all the time. Lots of people are using these shuttles, and they're a very reliable way to get around campus. How often do events happen on campus, like concerts and famous speakers? So we have events happening all the time. Nicole mentioned the first 6 weeks programming, and it doesn't end after 6 weeks. Things are still going on. So at your first floor meeting after you move in, your RA is going to share a lot of calendar things with you, and you might be overwhelmed, like, oh my gosh, there's so much to choose from. There really are. There's literally something for everybody. I can't remember the name of the website now, but there's a website where, all of your social activities and things like that on Emory's campus, everything is listed out there. And so there's a lot of opportunities. Someone asked Jimmy Carter. Yes, he does the Carter lecture for first year students. And that's typically in September, September. And so as a first year student, you have free entrance to that. And so you come and you get to see and hear Jimmy Carter speak, and it's pretty awesome.
So are we allowed to bring our own printers? Yes. But again, we do have printers for you here as well.
Questions about rugs, you're welcome to bring a rug if you'd like to. Do common kitchens have microwaves and refrigerators? Yes, they do.
And depending on which residence hall, we provide other things as well, just like other standard kitchen facilities and those kitchen supplies you can check out with Residence Life. So in terms of campus safety.
Yeah, so question about campus safety at night and the Emory police, what can I do to stay safe? There is an app that you can download as one thing, right, that you can do. So you can kind of activate this app as you're walking if you don't feel safe. There are, plenty of well-lit pathways and things like that. Emory Police is always available to assist. There is also I'm blanking on the name of it right now, but there is a kind of a safe ride, safe walk escort thing that you can do anytime the shuttles are not in service. So some folks will choose to do that if it's particularly early in the morning and they want to go walk across campus or things like that. So there's, you know, we definitely take safety seriously here on campus, and we are always trying mm-hmm. to think of ways to improve that and to enact things. And the Emory police here are great. I will definitely say that.
Dimensions. So furniture dimensions that can be found back earlier in the slides. We have a link to all the furniture dimensions for the Dobbs wardrobes in particular.
Yeah. Or if you just go to our website, emory.edu/housing, if you click on the upper bar, it says living on campus.
Oh, there we go.
And then there we go. Perfect.
There's a link
it's
right
linked
there.
In there. So any other last-minute burning questions that you're interested in before we wrap up here? How big is the Emory campus? Great question. We are a small but large campus, I would say. We have a number of residence halls. There's also a number of academic buildings on campus mm-hmm. and then other activity spaces on campus. We are nicely nestled in between some major roads here in kind of what's known as the Clifton Corridor. And so it can feel busy, it can feel big, but it can also feel small if that's what you're interested in.
Mm-hmm.
Someone said 631 acres. Thank you for that. Can you talk about Songfest one more time?
Yay! Okay, yeah. So Songfest. So Songfest is going to be like our annual, you know, tradition. And so this takes place the day after school starts. So school starts the 28th, Songfest is the 29th. This is going to be a competition between residence halls. So basically, to like paint the picture for you, each residence hall has a different t-shirt that's designed by the residence life staff that are gonna be working in that building. And every student is going to learn like a song and dance routine and come out and perform in front of the other residence halls. And so at the end of it, it's like a very big point of pride if you win Songfest.
Yes.
And there's multiple ways that you can win, whether it's like banner design, t-shirt design, or just the performance design. But I would say that all four years of students, so like juniors and seniors, even come out to watch this event. It's very well attended, and people really have a lot of pride for their residence hall. So it's just a great experience. It's a lot of fun.
There, you'll see alumni that will come back and, you know, watch this. They get local Atlanta celebrity judges.
Mm-hmm.
It's usually someone from one of the radio shows in the mm-hmm. area or things like that. And say they will actually judge the performances and then unveil the winner. It is a huge kickoff to your first year.
Mm-hmm.
Even not your first year, if you come back, you know, to watch it your sophomore year and later on, it's just really exciting and a lot of fun. And definitely a great tradition. If you talk to people, alumni, you know, 10, 20, 30 years later about what do they remember about their time at Emory, almost all of them will talk about Songfest because mm-hmm. it just is such a great tradition here on campus. Someone's asking about Wonderful Wednesdays. So Wonderful Wednesdays are just that. They are Wonderful Wednesdays. They're around the lunchtime. And in Asbury Circle, which is kind of one of the central pedestrian areas on campus, there will be tables and booths and things set up by different Emory clubs and activities and groups and stuff like
mm-hmm.
that. And so it's a great way to kind of get information about new groups on campus. There's usually giveaways, free things, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Those start...
I would say to check out the website
yeah.
For like specific details with Wonderful Wednesdays. There's also programming through the same office, so through the SILT office. That's what our involvement office is called here. There is also going to be like a programming called Dooley After Dark. And so that's a really fun way to just like get engaged on campus and just hang out with students later at nighttime.
Mm-hmm. Question about bike racks. Yes, there are bike racks where you can lock your bike during class. There are also bike racks outside the residence halls that you can secure your bike at. And on campus, we have something called the Fixie Shop that's actually located in the parking garage, the LSM parking garage, but any student can access it. You don't have to live in LSM. And that's a kind of a co-op shop of Emory students put this together, and it's a way that you can have your bike serviced or flat tires repaired, things like that.
Service bike. That'd be the same answer.
Yeah, so that would be the Fixie there. Okay, so it looks like the questions have pretty much died down for us. If you think of anything after this ends, feel free to email us, again, housing@emory.edu. And we are, you know, happy to assist you, answer any questions that you have ahead of move-in. We look forward to welcoming all of you to campus very shortly. Again, we're 1 month out from the traditional move-in day. If you are moving in early for a pre-approved program, you know, we're a little less than a month out, but we are looking forward to welcoming you to campus. We cannot wait to see you and meet you and share more about Emory with you at that point. But for the meantime, we are going to sign off and have a great rest of the summer, everybody.